Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys some markers today. Now, next to your media pool and your effects, you have an index. This is normally on edit index, and this shows you an EDL of your timeline, and that can be audio, video, subtitles, text. Any clip you have on your timeline will be listed here as an event. Then you have tracks, and then the third one over is a section for markers. Now, markers, you can add them to your timeline using Command M, and you get this dialog box. It automatically gives you a section where you can name it really quick, and then you can hit Tab to move over to the other sections. You can also remove these markers. Now, in the middle, we have these two icons that sort of look similar. One's like a little triangle. And then next to this, we have the markers. You can click on it and add one, then double click to name it. But the Command M gives you a faster way to manipulate it. Now, sometimes you'll have your video selected and you'll hit Command M, and you can see the dialog box pops up in a little bit different of a spot. And if I hit done, we don't have a timeline marker. We actually have a clip marker. And if you have your audio and video selected, you'll actually put a marker on both. Now, you think if you right click, this is giving you some marker shortcuts here, and you say remove all markers. Well, that'll remove only these timeline markers and not clip marker. And you can't right click on it and have a shortcut, but you can select it and hit delete. So that's one way you can get rid of them. Or if you have a whole bunch of clips on your timeline with a bunch of markers and you didn't realize it, you need to get rid of them. You can select all your media, so Command A, and then come over to your drop down here and hit clear all. And that'll actually clear whatever's selected, but leave your timeline markers alone. If you do an in and an out, and you go back to your in and you hit a marker, you can add a marker, and you can double click it, and then you get other options right here with this sub menu. So it says you can convert in and out to a duration marker. So now, if you had a section you needed to work on, you wanted it mapped out for wherever a shot was or a couple clips, you now have a duration marker. And as you can see, if we click on this marker, it actually shows this duration up here in our marker list. And this is useful if we go over to the Fusion tab. Let's say we had to do some special effects work. Underneath our spline editor, there's also markers available here. So you could kind of keep track of stuff here, although I don't know if you can navigate. You can move them around, but it doesn't really pop up with any info. But on the color page, you can see we still have markers in the timeline in this duration. And the shift up and down arrows also work. And you get the markers in your little display window, so you can find out what your note is on it. And if you have a duration marker, you can see how long that is and where the time code ends. So you can use the markers on those other two pages as well. What I do when I'm making YouTube videos is come over to my media pool and I click on timelines. And then from your timeline, right click timelines, and then you can export right here timeline markers to EDL. And that'll give you a little dialog box, and it'll export all these markers as an EDL. And give you a chance to name it. Now you have it as an EDL, and then if you go to the William Justice website, you can drag and drop that EDL and make chapter markers out of it. One thing I forgot to show you, under your index, under your markers, you can actually filter these with the three-dot menu for different colors. So here I got this purple one here, the rest are blue. This is useful if maybe color notes are blue and special effects works are yellow. If you have other people or you want to just map out different colored markers for different tasks, you can filter them over here in the marker index and blow through your notes. Or if you're making new notes with somebody else, like reviewing your project, and you don't want them combined in with these, you can always make some different colored markers. Now, to make different color markers, you have to use this drop down. It defaults to blue. So even if you hit Command M and choose another color and you hit done, that one is the color that you had selected. But the next time you go to make another new marker, it's going to go back to the blue color. So in order to get it to be a new set of colors for every insert, you need to choose it from here first. So if we want to start making red markers, we've now switched it to red. It, of course, made a mark there. But now if we add subsequent markers, it'll be whatever the last chosen color is. So the only other way you can change your marker color other than manually is with the speed editor on the cut page. there's a shortcut key. You can double tap and hit mark and hold it, and it will pop up a little wheel here, and you can add, but it doesn't actually give you a chance to give the note. So it just depends on if you want to make a bunch of different colored markers that way or not, but I hardly ever use the cut page for that. All right, thanks for watching. See you guys on the next one.